Good afternoon. Welcome to the Amelia G. Tabor Center for the Arts. My name is Jason Hedden. I'm the chair of Visual and Performing Arts here, and I'm thrilled you chose to spend your afternoon with us. If you are used to coming to our spring musical concert, you may notice some people missing from the program. The good news is our music program has grown so much in the last 2 years that we've had to separate instrumental and vocal music. So that's a great thing. So, tonight, or this afternoon rather, is the instrumental, and a week from today, same place, same location. That's the same thing, isn't it? Same place, same day of the week, same time, a different date. There you go. A week from right now, you get to see the singing Commodores in the concert chorale. But this afternoon is going to be great. If you don't know, our instrumental programs at Gulf Coast, ensembles rather, had been dormant for about a decade. And then Dr. Randall Haynes came in, he resurrected the program about a year and a half ago. But the two professors that are directing today's ensembles joined us just in January, and we couldn't be more excited to have Professor Christopher Rochester and Professor Chris John Vine with us. Let me check my notes. I should be making sure I'm saying everything I need to say. There's a few folks that join us as guest musicians that didn't make the printing of the playbill. I'll let the directors introduce them. We're also going to have a short intermission between the jazz ensemble and the concert band, so we can do a little bit of a switchover. I'd like to ask that you would not take photos or recording devices. If you look around you, you'll see some blinking lights in the theater. The theater is equipped with robotic cameras, and just on the other side of the wall there, Commodore Productions is doing a professional recording, and you all will have access to that. So their photos and recordings are much better than anything you can take on your cell phone, and it won't distract the folks around you. A special thanks to my colleagues, Brian and Erica, who are in the booth, who do so much for us. Erica Jones and her team, Commodore Productions.
The student art show is going on in the gallery, if you had a chance to check that out. If not, check it out during intermission. And I would be remiss if I didn't mention that registration is open for summer and fall classes. So if you like what you see today, or you know a person that might want to be involved in the arts here at Gulf Coast, help us spread the word, they can come see me. And I also want to let you know that we have a working recording studio right here in our building. I think Dr. Dave Schwartz is here today. He'd love to have you join the recording classes. We're releasing some albums that are being recorded right here in our building. Special thank you to Dr. Christine Yoshikawa and Professor Carissa Hosey, our full-time music faculty, who organize and make everything happen. So that's enough out of me. I'd like to turn it over to the Gulf Coast State College Jazz Ensemble and special guests under the direction of Professor Christopher Rochester. Thank you.
Thank you. Good afternoon, everyone. How's everyone doing? So, if you haven't gathered, I am Chris Rochester. I am the new professor of, I guess we could say, jazz here at Gulf Coast State College. And does anyone know that tune? Anyone recognize that George Gershwin song? Right? It's a little different. We changed it up, and we featured the amazing Ryan Jermison on trombone. Give him a round of applause. So as I was pondering what songs we should play for this concert, Ryan is one of my students. I give him private lessons, and I asked him if he knows Summertime. He said no. I was like, okay. Well, I'm going to give you a solo, and good luck. So Ryan did a great job. It was a quick turnaround, and I mean, that's what jazz is. It's we're taking things you've heard and putting new spins on it. So you've never heard Summertime like that. So that was the premiere of that arrangement, and you're going to continue to hear some amazing music.
Thank you.
So how many people recognize that one? Good, because it's an original. All right. So on the first couple weeks, I kind of wanted to challenge these guys, and we all listened to a whole bunch of music, and I said, let's vote on a song to arrange. I'm not going to arrange it. You guys are. So we ended up listening to a whole bunch of songs, and we ended up choosing Dave Brubeck's Take Five. And I pause when I say the name, because they'll know. I always forget the names of the songs we're playing. I say song one, song two. This is song two, right?
Yeah,
that's song two, yeah. So this is Take Five, so it's song five. No, it's Take Five. And this is actually arranged by the Gulf Coast State College Jazz Band. Dig. So who's heard Take Five like that, huh? So that was them. I helped a little bit, right? Just a little.
Yeah.
Just a little.
Yeah.
That was mostly them. So as we wrap up this this fun occasion, fun evening, fun afternoon, I don't know what time it is, I'd like to invite out a special guest, Miss Brittany Reynolds. Is Brittany back there? Give it up for Brittany Reynolds. Now, Brittany wasn't our only special guest today. We have some people sitting in that love music and are kind of pros already. Filling in for bass, this guy I met the other day. He's not bad, right? David is filling in for us on bass. Give it up for David. And then a good friend of mine that I worked with in the past, he studied with me for a small little bit. We went to the same high school. I think I graduated how many years before you did? Four? No, it was longer than that. I finished high school before you started middle school, so we went to the same high school, so he doesn't know. But Sean Villanueva on trumpet is filling in. Give it up for Sean. And give it up for this wonderful band. They've been doing an amazing job in the entire semester. I've been known to be a tough guy, apparently. It's an honor to work with you guys. And we're gonna end this amazing day, or I guess set, because the contraband's coming on after us. We're gonna end this set with I guess they don't need to know. They'll recognize it, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, you'll hear it. All right. Looking less 7 years of bad luck. We're gonna take a short intermission. Okay.
About half of the ensemble, actually more probably now, are people, are kids, students that we drew from the high schools in the local area, which is amazing that they're able to come. And I'd like to recognize them and give them a round of applause because they just did state MPA yesterday and did a fabulous job. So. We have a few students who are not in the program that I'd like to recognize. So we have David Chandler, who's from Mosley. He's a senior. We have Christian Honda, who's in Bay, who's also a senior. We have Alex Dean, who's at Bozeman, who is in eighth grade. We have Ben Weber from Bozeman, who's a senior as well. And Seth Leachman, who's in Bay, who's a junior. So their names did not make it into the program, but they are definitely in the ensemble, and I wanted to recognize that they were here. So we have three selections for you today. I have a special guest conductor coming for the second piece, which is the Game of Thrones, and I'll introduce him when we get done. The first piece is this Lion King arrangement. It's a pretty decent arrangement. It kind of holds a special place in my heart because my first clarinet teacher in undergrad, he played on the soundtrack to this with the New York Philharmonic. And some of my favorite memories in my lessons was him coming, or me coming to the lesson and being like, hey, I have this run. I remember from playing E-flat clarinet when we played this in piece, and he'd just sit there and play, and it was so cool to me. So when I was looking for music to do this one, it was a good arrangement, and I was like, well, it's got some significance for me. So yeah, the first piece is Lion King. I hope you guys enjoy it.
Thank you. Thank you.
All right, so for our next selection, we have a Game of Thrones arrangement. And when we were first started working on this, this is my first concert here being the director of the concert band. And I really wanted to bring somebody special to kind of help me with this. So the person who's coming tonight, his name's Cody Smith. He does a lot of things in the community, for those of you who don't know, teaches at Northside Elementary. He's a fantastic musician. He plays cello with the Pops. He just got done playing a concert yesterday with the Northwest Florida Symphony, and they played Beethoven 5 and all these other great pieces. I played with him many, many times in orchestra and undergrad together. That's where we met. We actually went to high school together as well. But he's a fantastic musician. I couldn't think of anybody else I wanted to share this spotlight, I guess you could call it, with him. So I'd like to bring Cody Smith out. And the best part is, if you guys watch Game of Thrones, he actually looks like someone who's from Game of Thrones. So that's the other reason why he fits it really well. But thank you so much, Cody, and
absolutely.
Turn it over to you.
So we were at rehearsal one night, because that's where I'm always at, and in case you're wondering, and John approached me and said, I would love to have you conduct a piece. I was thinking, okay, great, well, should it be Mozart or Bach? He said, I wanted to do Game of Thrones, and I was like, why Game of Thrones? I really don't understand why it would be me to do the Game of Thrones. And he explained to me it was because I was a colleague and we had gone to not only high school together, but undergrad, and played a lot throughout the years together. And it's a great pleasure to be here. And one thing that I was super impressed about was that our rehearsals were often on the weekend and in the day for this performance. And it is incredibly difficult to get your students to school on a weekend, on a morning, especially college students on a Saturday morning that are music majors or not. Anyways, this is a great program, great conductor as well, and I can't wait to see for the future of the program. Thank you.
All right, so for our last piece, I depict something that was part of the standard band repertoire, because not that our local high schools don't always do this, but we don't always play the best music available for wind ensemble, just because a lot of times we don't have the needs to do it, or we don't have a big enough section for something or other like that. And hardly it ever gets played anymore, at least in this area, because our bands are a lot smaller than they used to be, like back in the 80s. But Gustav Holst, He's an interesting composer. He's, for those of you who don't know, he's English. His claim to fame is the Planet Suite, which gets used quite frequently for movie music and commercials. Notably, the Mars and Jupiter. Those are the two that get played quite often, and they're fantastic orchestral works. And he kind of brings some of that flavor as far as the dense orchestration to his band pieces. He wrote two band pieces that he wrote actually several, but the two that get played most often are two suites for band. There's the first suite in E flat, which we're playing, and there's the second suite in F. They're considered probably the most, probably maybe not popular, but probably the most widely accepted like classic band pieces, at least from as far as the English repertoire is concerned. So we'll be playing the first and third movements from the first suite. It features some pretty interesting things. A lot of middle voice kind of stuff, so a lot of French horn and like the lower reeds and a lot of like middle voices that you don't normally hear a lot of time, because a lot of time in band we get a lot of top voice and a lot of middle usually. So the middle voices hold a key role to this piece especially. And this is one that's one of my favorite band pieces to play, and so that's why I picked it. And people here are more than capable of playing, and they're doing a fantastic job with it. So we'll close our concert with First Suite in E flat.
Thank you, folks. Let's hear it again one more time for the concert band. And the jazz ensemble. And there's something special about musicians. All these volunteers that joined both ensembles, that really impresses me. Thank you all so much. A week from today is our vocal music concert, so if you had fun today, come on back next week or help us spread the word. As you leave, Danielle is going to be in the lobby there with a box that says Music Scholarships. If you got a few bucks you'd like to throw inside to help us continue to do what we're doing here at Gulf Coast, we would appreciate it very much. If not, this was our gift to you. Thank you so much, and have a great afternoon.